Hey guys, and welcome back to Professor Layton and the Curious Village. Our story so far. The Professor and Luke continue their investigation around St. Mystia for the Golden Apple. Conversations with the Baron's associates lead the pair to the grave of the Baron's former wife. In addition, the two recover a part of Baron Reinhold's personal journal. Regardless of this, Luke and Layton are no closer to understanding just what the Golden Apple is. The menacing tower at the edge of St. Mystia has roused the Professor's suspicions. Eager to investigate further, Luke and Layton head in its direction. So we're finally heading off to the tower, I believe. Oops, that's not where I wanted to go. This guy here looks new. Good day, gentlemen. How's your investigation coming along? I can't imagine it's much fun asking questions all day, so how about a puzzle to liven things up? The Sound of Silence, puzzle number 72, worth 40 picarats. Which of these words doesn't make the sound of silence? Doesn't make the sound of silence. What's the sound of silence? Okay, so it has to be only one of them, so it's not a trick question. Which of these words doesn't? I guess chord. When you see a group of words that have a similar theme, it's easy to get hung up on their meaning. Instead, look for other ways to interpret the question asked of you. For example, other than a very literal definition, what else could the sound of silence be referring to? Rest? Which of these doesn't make the sound of silence? Read each word out loud and pay attention to how they differ from each other. In particular, think about how each word is pronounced. Okay. Oh, hang on. Chord. Or is it rhythm? I guess rhythm has a silent H. But then, like, doesn't make the sound of sound, so silent letter. Silent letter, I guess. Silent letter, silent letter, silent letter, so rest. Maybe. I think that was right. Excellent. That's right. The answer is rest. All of the other options have silent letters. Yeah, there we go. I guess the old advice to write what you know doesn't apply here. That was just too easy. You know, right now I'm penning a mystery novel, and I'm basing the protagonist on you. This is why I've been observing you so carefully. In fact, the more I see of you, the better. So good luck with your search, I'll be watching. Layton probably wants a reading lamp. I'd say. Does he have another puzzle? Do not be alarmed by my piercing gaze. This is for research purposes only. No. This dude probably does, though. Nothing good can be said about that tower. I heard it's all sorts of scary. You should stay away, yep. Let's head on to the tower. I mean, should I still be looking for hint coins, do you reckon? They've probably reset, right? Maybe not. Anyway, let's head up. Well, if it isn't you two again. Alright, if you want your fortunes told, solve this puzzle for me. Puzzle 74, a broken window worth 30 picarats. Four kids were playing, and one of them threw a ball right through your window. Here's what they had to say for themselves. Not me, I didn't break a thing. Okay, I'll tell the truth. It was me. I broke it. Don't be mad at A. He didn't do anything. B didn't break the glass, I swear. You know for a fact that the scamp who broke your window is lying. However, an unknown number of other children may be lying as well. Can you figure out which one of these darned kids broke your window? Okay, this is hard because normally it's like one of them is telling the truth. But this one's saying that all of them could be. Right, so if A is lying, not me, I didn't break a thing, then he did break it. Which means... B would be lying as well. C would also be lying, and D would be telling the truth, because B didn't break the glass since A broke it. This is kind of dumb. Okay, so we say that B is definitely lying. Okay, I'll tell the truth, but I'm lying, so he didn't, which means... A could be telling the truth, and C could be telling the truth, but D might also be lying. If C's lying, don't be mad at A, he didn't do anything. Then A did it, which means C and A are lying, and B is lying, and D is telling the truth. I'm not entirely convinced this is possible with the information at hand. This one's sort of a pain, isn't it? The kid who broke the window is certainly lying, but you can't forget that a number of the other children might be lying as well. We've already established that the child who actually broke the window lied. Therefore, the child who broke the window must have denied breaking the window when confronted. In other words, B couldn't have broken the window, and D must be telling the truth about B. Okay. We know that they're lying. The scamp who broke your window is lying. Okay, so it can't be B because he's telling the truth. And if it's not B, then D is also telling the truth, right? I see that. A says, it's not me, I didn't break a thing, and C says, don't be mad at A, he didn't do anything. Because if C did it, then A is not lying. But if C did it, then they have to be lying, so then it's A. If C did it, I mean, the person who broke the window has to be lying, so that makes C a liar. B and C were also lying about what happened, even though they themselves didn't break the glass. Make sure you give those two a good scolding as well. Into the dungeons. There's going to be a doozy of a rainstorm tomorrow. Hang your wash inside if you want it to dry. Thanks, Agnes. What about old Georgie? No, Giuseppe. That's what I said. You sure I can't interest you in a nice cut of veal? It's a veal deal. Ha ha ha. Off to the tower. There's got to be some hint coins here. Never been here before. There's a hidden puzzle here. Red and blue, one. Puzzle number 119, worth 40 picarats. This looks fun. The box below holds blue and red balls. As you can see, the colour of the balls and the colour of their respective areas don't match. Slide the balls around the box so that the red balls are in the red area and the blue balls are in the blue area. Okay. I like these puzzles. Even if it's going to take me a little bit to get through. I think I need to calibrate my screen. Definitely not the ideal amount of turns, but we're getting there. There we go. 180 turns. Hope it tells me what the minimum is. This puzzle can be done in 30 moves. Okay. That was close. That puzzle is a tough one. Thanks. Where though? Whereabouts? Thanks, buddy. Old mate Gizmo coming in handy. Didn't find that one though, did you, Gizmo? Useless. Oh, what's that on the ground? It appears to be a scrap of paper. Can you please read what's written on it, Luke? Leave it to me, Professor. The boss hasn't been himself since Lady Violet's passing, and he shows no signs of recovering. That's why I've decided I'll make one as a tribute to Lady Violet. I'm sure it will put a smile on his face. Ah, yes, now it makes sense. Could our mystery author be him? I've worked my fingers to the bone trying to cheer up the boss. Looking out over St. Mystia, I see a thriving, bustling village. With so many villages to keep him company, maybe he can finally be happy again. That's the end of the page. Professor, what's the matter? You look deep in thought. I can't confirm my suspicions at the moment, but I think it's safe to say this goes deeper than we thought. Alright, give me a sec, I was getting there. Lots of hint coins. Getting our storage back up. Our stockpile, I mean. Oh me, oh my. It's not every day I see a handsome buck around these parts. Your looks are impressive, dearie, but let's see if you've got smarts. Try this puzzles on for size. I'd be happy to solve any puzzle you have, madam, but I don't believe we've met before. You are. You want to know my name, dearie? I'll tell you as soon as you solve this puzzle. Her accent is, not... consistent. Puzzle number 102, Aces and the Joker, worth 40 picrats. You've scattered a deck of 52 cards and one joker face down on a table so that you don't know which card is where. Next, you start turning the cards over one by one. Assuming that you can't flip the same card twice, what are the percentage odds that you will turn over all four aces before you turn over the joker? Oh god. What are the percentage odds that you... scattered a deck of 52 cards and one joker face down on the table so that you don't know which card is where. Next, you start turning the cards over one by one, assuming you can't flip the same card twice, what are the percentage odds that you'll turn over all four aces before you turn over the joker? Percentage odds. Well, is it? Has to be an easy percentage, because this game wouldn't make kids do like fraction percentages. Turn over all four aces before you turn over the joker. This first hint's gonna be useless. It's gonna be like, it's not as difficult as you might think. Out of 53 cards, 4 are aces. Each time you flip a card, the probability of turning over an ace increases. But you really don't need to work out any of that. Think about what you can do to eliminate other variables to consider. What other variables can I? I hate probability. If you distill this question down to its simplest form, it's just asking you how likely it is you'll flip over four aces in any order before you turn over the joker. The other 48 cards have nothing to do with the problem. So, we have basically 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1 in 5, so I'm gonna say like 80%. This is just a guess, I don't expect it to be right at all. No. Not quite. Let's buy the last one, I guess. There are 5 cards that actually matter in this puzzle. Of those 5, the joker has to come last. What's the probability of flipping the joker? Okay, I went the wrong way. I mean, I still don't quite understand that. it may seem like you need to take other cards into account, no card in the deck save the... Oops. Oh, well. Yes, indeed, that's right. Schmatz and Luxh. You're just the total package, aren't you? I'm Martha, and I just love cards. Especially puzzles that use cards. Oh, those are my favourites. I don't think I've mentioned how much I also enjoy the company of handsome gentlemen. Professor, don't we have somewhere to be right now? Yeah, that's not one of my favourites. Let's see if she has another puzzle. She does not. I think this is a dead end. And this does appear to be the only road, doesn't it? Gosh, that tower sure looks awfully ominous, doesn't it? Seeing it up close, I can understand why the villagers are so scared of the place. Let's take a closer look at this wall. There might be more to it than meets the eye.
Seek access to the tower. Do you think you could help us, miss?
The tower?
Oh, wait!
What in the world was that about? Professor, what's this? A Ferris wheel ticket? Very curious indeed. Luke, that girl may have dropped this to tell us where we should head next. But why would she want to help us? Your guess is as good as mine, Luke. Still, I can't shake the feeling that she's trying to help us. Well, your intuition hasn't ever been wrong. Let's see what we can find around the park's Ferris wheel. Yeah, that's right, Leighton. Go straight to the park. You've been a thorn in my side for too long. I think it's about time for you to disappear. For good. 60% of the way through this game, we finally have a antagonist. Chapter 6 complete. That was a super short chapter. Bloody hell. Thank you, Gizmo. All right, let's head to the park. Wait, she probably has another puzzle for me now. Nope, she does not. I was gonna say, I wonder if these hint coins are back. I think these games are really cool because they're just like static scenes, so you get some really nice artwork, but it doesn't take away from the gameplay. The gameplay is like still really good, and I think they just made it really well. I feel like the music gonna be louder. I'm going to assume that they don't have any puzzles for me, since they didn't before. I wonder if this guy has a puzzle for me. Nope. What about you? That's rude. This park has been closed every time we've come by. Why do you suppose that is, Professor? I haven't the foggiest idea. Perhaps we should ask someone at the town hall. Yeah. Chapter 7, The Abandoned Park. Does the park hold the way into the tower? Search the park grounds to find out. Right, where's the town hall? I have no idea which building the town hall is. So that's going to be a problem. Oh, this is the town hall. That's alright then. What's that you say? The gate to the park is locked shut? No, that's impossible. We've employed a caretaker who should have everything up and running. Be that as it may, the gate is locked shut, and we can't gain entrance to the place. Would you please open it up for us? That sort of thing is the job of the park caretaker. I strongly advise you to go find him. Well, where do you think we might find this caretaker? Now that's a good question, isn't it? Managing the park is the caretaker's duty. But who knows who manages the caretaker? I can't say. It's not one of my duties. What a bureaucracy. He managed the town sewer systems as well. Now, unless you have some form you need to fill out, I strongly advise you to beat it. Gosh, he's rude. The sewers. Unpleasant as it might be, it is one place we haven't searched yet. Perhaps we will find a clue to our mystery down there. I've only seen one manhole in town. Oh, right, the one on the path to the park. Well, it's a dirty job, but someone has to do it. Off we go. It's open and everything. Isn't that lucky? Give me a chance to search at least, bloody hell. Oops, did that just put me back up? No. Oh look, Professor, I found a hidden puzzle. Puzzle number 120. Get the ball out. 3. This puzzle is worth 60 picarats. Can you get the red ball out of the maze? Slide obstructing blocks out of the way to clear a path for the ball. This problem can be solved in 20 moves. Yeah, but it won't be, so... I really do like these puzzles as well. The sort of rush hour puzzles. Well, that's not at all helpful. Can this go down here? Oh, I sure can. There we go. Interesting. Okay. So it's a bit different to rush hour in that blocks can go sort of anyway. By the looks of things. Nope, I think I messed up here. So it's actually harder since they can go multiple ways. I'd have to use a hint coin, I think. There are 5 empty spaces to work with here, but when you start, you have some bothersome long blocks in the way. To remedy this, first you should move the lower right blue block and slide the purple block formally to the left of it down into the space with the hole. Now you should be able to move the big yellow block down. Yep, I know how to do that, thank you. That's not that entirely helpful. Seem to be getting somewhere now. Maybe. Nope, that's much worse. There we go. Whatever. Good enough. Not quite 20 moves, but at least we got it. Piece of cake. Now let's go find more puzzles. Where? Here. There we go. Thank you. Excuse me. Are you by any chance the park caretaker? No, I am an explorer of El Mundo. Right now, I am trying to familiarize myself with the local culture. Oh, please pardon my mistake then. Have a pleasant day, sir. Oh, wait for one momento, s'il vous plaît. I just saw a man in work clothes pass here. Could he be the caretaker you seek? He could be. Which way did he go? Probably to the right. Pero, maybe it was the left. Pero. I see. Are you feeling alright? You seem a bit directionally challenged for being an explorer. I just arrived here after years of world travel. Je ne sais pas the local geography here, that's all. I see. In that case, please forgive me for making another assumption. Now please excuse us as we need to get going. Wait, which way to the Villaggio? Donde está the train station? No wonder I can't get an accent for this dude, he's like speaking 4 different languages. Well he said right, so let's go right. Well, this dude looks shifty. Ho there. Now what can I do you fellows for? You are the park caretaker, are you not? Would you mind opening up the gate to the park for us? Well, how could I refuse two curious lads such as yourselves? Well, I'd like to open it up for you, but I've got to finish this repair job here before I do anything. Is there anything we can do to help then? Funny you should mention that. If I could just figure out the area on this map, I'd be done in a jiff. You any good with things like that? Area? No. Not maths, please. Puzzle 86, squares and circles, worth 30 picarats. Sylvain brought you this diagram to see if you can help him with it. Several circles and squares are pictured in the diagram below. How many times larger is the area of the blue square when compared to that of the red square? Not cool. Not cool at all. It looks like 2.5 anyway. Do you see the circle that touches the sides of the big blue square? A smaller square sits inside the circle and touches it. Since the square is smaller than the circle, you can rotate it within the circle. Yes, genius. This rotation has made it so that the red square's corners now make contact with the middle square. No, I got rid of it. From the rotation described in the second hint, draw two perpendicular lines from the outer circle through the middle to divide the squares into four quadrants. Do this and you'll see the middle square's area is equal to half of the blue squares. Not really sure which way perpendicular should be. Like this. Anyway, I think it's four. Yeah. Maths is always my weakest point in these, unfortunately. If you rotate the middle square 45 degrees as shown in the picture above, the answer becomes apparent. Does it though? It doesn't. Oh, like that. Right. Fair enough. Fine work, the both of you. Soon as I take care of this busted main, I'll open that gate for you. There, that ought to take care of this mess. Now let's open up the park, eh? Found a painting scrap. Just hold on one second here. There we are. The park is yours to explore now. Professor, we're in. Thank you. You've been of great help, caretaker. Pretty sure he has a name. I hardly need thinking, sir. After all, this is me job. Way back when, I used to keep it open every day, but these villagers, they don't care a whit for me park. I'm glad you fellows stopped by. It's the first time in a while I've had to do me job. Well, that's not something you should be admitting freely. Let's have a look at this painting. Must have a fair few scraps by now. This is going to be a bit difficult, I think, until I start getting the right amount of pieces. Well, I reckon that one goes like here. Which means that one would go like... not like that, I don't think. Those definitely go together, though. Okay. Nope, one of these isn't right. Hang on, what if this is a top piece? Oop, stop that. Does that make sense there? Yeah, I think it does. So I can switch this back and bring this one back up here. No, there's a piece in between those. Let's grab some of this window. Does that look around there? I think so. Whatever that is, that goes there, I think. Got a fair bit of this painting, actually. That doesn't look like it goes there. Alright, I've only got like 3 pieces left of this, I think. But I think we might actually call that an episode there. So I'd like to thank you for joining me for some more Professor Layton and the Curious Village. We're up to chapter 7 of 9, I believe, now, so we're getting close to the end. It's only taken me about a year. But I do hope to see you next time.